Game on, it's about to go down. A juke can't shake it all up. My moves make them run them up. I'm lit, so you know what's up. I got the party going up. A champ with the crown is here. I'ma win anywhere. Hey, so shake it like you don't care. I shake it up everywhere. And I can bake cakes by the pound. Blow the whistle cause I love that sound. And we can just keep going round.
It's time for the NFL playoffs on EA Sports, and we are in a city that sure had its share of memorable playoff games in the past. Pittsburgh, PA at Heinz Field. Straight ahead, we punch the second of two tickets to the AFC title game, and we've got a great one in store between the Cleveland Browns and the Pittsburgh Steelers. For a berth in the AFC championship game, off we go in the divisional round of the NFL playoffs. This will make it into the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
Take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Start with the option. And he'll take it ahead to the 28-yard line. Decided to hand it off that time on the run-pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice steady gain.
Six yards on that last play. Here's second and four. Mayfield firing quickly. It's complete. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. Just three catches in the wild card victory form a week ago, and now he's got his first here, and it's good for a first down. Field leaves it for Hunt on the draw. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 13 yards to pick up there. Good for a Cleveland first.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run. And let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down. Otherwise, it's going to be a long afternoon.
They go play action here on first down. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest one is maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability, and a sack resulted.
Some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21. Another try after the first down sack. Mayfield, and it's hauled in by Austin.
Hooper. Complete to Austin Hooper. A pickup of 15 yards, but it's now third down.
Good job.
midfield now from the 50. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off around the 27. And he's able to bring it up 5 yards shy of midfield to the 45-yard line. And certainly, look, you're on the road in the playoffs. That is a suboptimal start, opening drive INT.
And, partner, sometimes I wonder, do these teams talk about it to such an extent that maybe you almost talk yourself into the turnover when you're trying to avoid it?
Yeah, maybe they get a little too worried about keeping the football, and then you give it to the other team right off the bat. And look, we said it, on the road, this is just a terrible, terrible start for them.
It is, and now they've got to rely on their defense. Usually we see runs like this as the defense breaks down later in the game, but this guy is setting the tone early, running through all types of tackles and put the defense back on its heels.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line.
Mac Wilson on the tackle.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
And caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Steelers. Deontay Johnson, 37 yards. And the Steelers have taken a first quarter lead. One of the keys to their long winning streak has been scoring first. An ideal drive right there, getting the first 6 points of the ball game.
Do you go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator? What he told us?
Absolutely.
With some teams, a script to probe in the early part of the game. Other teams, I script to attack. They've been in attack mode for these ball games and continue that in this one.
And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
The Browns take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The Browns drive about to get started. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 to score as they start first and 10. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down. Seemed like a couple sets of eyes were on the quarterback, so he decided, hey, I'm going to hand this off. Got a good gain out of it.
And you know you need good blocking up front in order to gain yardage, but every one of these RPOs, if you do it right and they look the same, whether it's handed off inside or the quarterback keeps it, that allows you to fool the defense so often. And in this case, fooled them with the inside run.
Second and 10 from the 33-yard line. Out of the gun, they run it with Hunt. And the hole closes quickly. He gets it across the 35 to the 36-yard line. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and 7 ahead.
Gain on the play. Brings up third down.
Out right. Now he'll let it go deep right side. And that's caught inside the 30. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Call that a gain of 38. A big march forward on the third down conversion. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Here's Mayfield. Blitz coming, and down he goes. Oh, Jim Nwosu coming in hard there on the blitz, and he gets him 7 yards behind the line of scrimmage.
It's second down.
So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. Another try after the first down sack. Mayfield. And boy, that one drops incomplete, but if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble.
Though he's seen some good pressure defensively already here in the first quarter, here's another good example.
Play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. And now with the play clock getting down, Kevin Stefanski going to take a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Mayfield. There goes a deep ball in zone. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Mike Hilton. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the shot downfield, they were more than prepared for that one.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. He's going to wind up and air it out.
And this might not be the last interception we see, Brandon. Both of these teams like to throw the football, but here in this snow, ball's not going to always go where you want it to. And this one winds up getting intercepted.
Mayfield going to lead the Browns up now, first and 10, right at the 50-yard line. Running with Hunt here out of the shotgun. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. That's good for a Cleveland first down and 11-yard pickup.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Play fake. Mayfield. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Number two. A good pickup there for the Browns, 15 yards.
How about a guy proving his worth in different ways? Had the big play in the run game to play before. This time, they go right back to him in the passing game, and he comes through with yet another big play. That's why you work out so hard in the offseason, so you can stay on the field and accumulate big plays.
It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4.
Brings up second and 4.
Mayfield gives this one to Hunt, and they'll get him down right around the 16.
Hunt again, the ball carrier.
It'll be a pickup of a couple, and it leaves him with a 3rd and 3.
That's the end of the first quarter with the score Steelers 7, Browns nothing.
Trying to run for the first down with Hunt. And Hunt is not going to get there. Just a yard on the run there. That's going to bring us to a 4th down.
But forget knowing where the first down line was.
This defense created their own line of scrimmage. They won every battle up front, and a lot of times that is one-on-one. And if you win your one-on-ones enough times, your defense is going to be pretty good. They had more people to the football and snuffed out the play.
So Kevin Stefanski going to take a chance, going for it on fourth. Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. The offense staying out. They're going to go on fourth and two. From the gun, Mayfield. Escaping the pressure right. He finds Beckham complete. That he will have the first down before he's tackled at the 12. Just a gain of three, but they'll certainly take it as they convert on fourth down. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. On the run, this is Hunt. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. From the shotgun, it's Mayfield. This will be caught at about the 6. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
And it's third down.
Working out of the gun, Mayfield. And that's going to be caught for a Browns touchdown. Odell Beckham there to make the grab. And the Browns are within an extra point of tying this thing up. And he's a little bit on the shorter side as a receiver. Maybe sometimes for the defense, tough to find the little guys, right?
Yeah, sometimes they get lost in the traffic. But usually what it means is that rather than just winning with height or even speed, they use their quickness to find a way to get open.
Well, tall, short, wide, skinny, whatever. There it results in a touchdown. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line.
At their own 23-yard line.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. They had the interception last drive, led to the tying touchdown. So 7-7 the score as they begin first and 10. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. He's going to go up top again and nearly picked off. But surprising to see a defender of his caliber let it get away. But it does get away and it's second down. Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side. And he'll be corralled right around the 34. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. They'll set up to throw. They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be caught. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. And they had a gain of 10 last time, now a gain of 20 here. So a first and 10 upcoming from Browns territory now at the 46. Now a handoff here to his running back. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and one.
Mac Wilson on the tackle. It's a gain of 9. Brings up second and a yard at the 38-yard line.
Now they try the right side here. And he's going to take this down close to a first down at the Browns 30. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks.
Yeah, once more, a strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
Back to throw now on first down. Will be caught, and he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. It's a gain of 22 as we tick towards the 2-minute warning. Second quarter action, 2 minutes to go on divisional round weekend. We remind you, as we've done all year, that coming up at halftime, we will visit with Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll let you know what's going on here on a very eventful divisional round weekend. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And the Steelers are going to have it first and goal as he'll take this down to about the 3. So that run gets him about halfway home.
Yeah, it's now second and goal. The end zone beckons. It looms. They can do whatever they want. Full playbook. Run it again, or they can go play action and try and put it in that way.
On second and goal, here's the option. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by Denzel Ward. He's at the 50. He's at the 30.
Do what we
10,
do. Do what we
5,
do.
And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Browns defense has a touchdown. And we'll see if that pick six looms large as this game continues, because we've seen plays like that alter a lot of playoff contests over the years.
I would agree with that totally. And you often think to yourself, why do they alter it so much? Because after games, don't we hear coaches and players say, well, one play doesn't usually determine the outcome? But I don't think that's really true, do you? Because there's times when we see plays like that, and all of a sudden the momentum jumps to that team side. It deflates the other side, and they never pick it back up. And then things really go from there, don't they?
That's the thing for me. We talk about momentum changes. A play like that is the ultimate momentum change. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he returns this to the 22.
Steelers take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't...
And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off at the 39. And he is going to get this one back to the 20-yard line. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. Give it here to his running back. And he'll push his way forward to about the 32.
Carried by number 21.
Sheldon Richardson there to make the play. The first down run got 5. Here's second and 5.
Brings up second and 5.
He'll look to throw. Going right side here, and that's complete. Now they're going to be dealing with a third and seven. Is that one officially a loss of one?
If you're a selfish player and you're throwing the ball, you're cool with the completion. Maybe not so cool with the yardage loss, though, huh?
Yeah, you went backwards on the yardage. Hey, it kind of works like a sack for the defense there.
Yeah, it's a really big play for them, right? Able to figure it out, sniff it out, and finish it off.
And the Browns' pressure gets to him that time, and he's going to go down. The Browns will quickly use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. So on now is the Clemson man, Bradley Pinion, to punt this one away. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. They'll score that a 36-yard punt, and the Browns will take over first and 10. The Browns drive about to get started. They're starting to put some space here. The first quarter, they didn't look so hot offensively. This second quarter, though, they've looked really good.
They've jumped in the saddle in a big way now, and now they're in full gallop. I mean, before, kind of cantering around a little bit, right, trying to feel their way, not getting done what they wanted to. But somehow they put it together with play calling, execution, and now there's a pretty big gap.
And they'll look to make that gap even bigger here. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
Timeouts, remember, so this is going to have to be a delay. And that'll set them back 5. So the delay of game penalty backs them up. It's now 2nd and 7. Field to throw it, sliding out of the pocket. And he's going to go down. They sack him back at the 42. Now the Steelers use the first of their 3 timeouts as the stoppage will come with 23 seconds to go till halftime. Mayfield and this Browns offense staring at a 3rd and long now after the sack. Throwing, Mayfield. They'll go screen here to Hunt, and he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. Now the Steelers use the 2nd of their 3 timeouts as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. The Browns send out their punter now as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. There on the punt, and control of the football switching hands with very little time remaining until the half. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. Likely time for just one final play, and then it'll be off to the locker room to talk about how they can erase this deficit.
Yeah, and I think a lot of people look at it and go, well, maybe you take a shot here, maybe you get some momentum going into the half. What's the flip side of that? You do something crazy, quarterback gets hit, ball comes free, and now you're down an even bigger margin. Go ahead and take this one, go to the locker room, start over.
And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards, and it's going to yield a new set of downs.
1st and 10 at the 40.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. They'll throw now on the final play. Wide open receiver complete. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. So it's on to halftime in this AFC divisional round matchup. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports halftime report. Coach, win or go home, that's the name of the game, and we're back underway with the second half of this AFC divisional round. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. They're close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess that in the locker room, they talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up.
Second and five at the 30-yard line.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and five. The shotgun now. Here's an inside give. He takes this from the 30 to the 34. And for the Browns, a nickel set here on third down.
A gain of four. Brings up third.
They'll drop the throw. He'll try to set up the screen. It's complete. And he will have a Steelers first down as they're able to convert on third and short yardage with a gain of four.
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play caller said that the screen pass was available. Whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. And it worked very well there for a first down.
And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
And again, this time to the tailback. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
So a first and 10 upcoming from Browns territory now at the 47. There's a quick throw right side, and it's complete. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. That catch good for only a couple.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
Here's second and eight. And they're going to have another first down as he's going to be tackled at the Browns' 25-yard line. A good pick up there of 20 yards.
That was good protection there. No, that was great protection there because it allowed him to lock in on his receiver, although I think he was looking for his tight end on the corner route all the way. Nice connection there for a really nice gain.
Now this one to his running back out of the backfield. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. 12 more yards there and another first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
2 yards the loss, second and 12.
No daylight for him to run through there, and he ran into the defensive tackle, and that guy blocks a whole lot of daylight as it is. He is truly a big man who just made a big play.
A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's second and 12. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. Flush to his right. And they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. This is out quickly to the right, and it looks like he'll be just a yard shy of the five here as he's out at the six. They do get nine, but it leads to fourth down.
Fourth down.
The offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on fourth and three. They'll try and run for it, and he's not even going to come close to picking up the first. They stop him right at the line of scrimmage. They'll get neither the touchdown nor the first down, and this Browns defense stands tall. The Browns drive about to get started. They're going to have to go at least 50, 60 yards here if they want to ensure that they don't have to punt the ball like they did last time.
Yeah, so what you're saying is we're not playing to just get out of the shadow of your own goal line, right? You're playing to make sure the punter doesn't see the field again. So it's not picking up a couple of first downs. You want to pick up five or six first downs and make sure you move the ball to their territory.
Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense? The next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. They go play action. Mayfield. And bringing it in right side here, Beckham. And he gets this one just shy of the 35 to the 34. Something we're seeing more of with the rise of the run-pass option. A legal man downfield, and that's going to back him up. Mayfield now on second down. Gets this to Kareem Hunt, his running back. And he'll get it up to the 12-yard line here. It'll be a gain of 8 yards. And all of a sudden here, it's third down. Throw, Mayfield. And Mayfield again with the interception, his third. Picked off at the 24. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six for a Steeler touchdown.
Chris Boswell.
Did I just see what I thought I saw? Did I just see what I thought that had to be? Come on, say it for me. Say it for me. Who picked up that pass?
A free safety.
Oh, you got to have those great skills back there. Eyes, anticipation, great hands. And, of course, how about the fluid moves afterwards to take it all the way to the house?
Sounds like you're watching your old game film up here in your head.
Yeah, oh, that's the dream I had of being that player. I just never was.
And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25.
First and 10 at their own 26-yard line.
The Browns drive about to get started. They'll start with Hunt on the ground. And he's going to get about 7 yards on that one, up to around the 33. So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a second and 3.
brings up second and three.
They run again with Hunt.
Kareem Hunt, the ball carrier. The tackle made at the 36-yard line. It's a gain of three.
First one quarter remains for the right to advance to the AFC title game. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Mayfield down. And finding the tight end Hooper. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. That'll move the sticks for the Browns, a gain of 12.
First down, Browns.
On first down, they'll run with Hunt. And he'll get this one across midfield and down into Steeler territory. They give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later. And let's face it, you could do worse than a 4 yard run on first down.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. Mayfield looks to throw. And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. The Browns on third down, lacking much success. Just 2 for 7 to this point. This will be third and six. That one is caught by Hunt. And he is going to have a Browns first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. 14 yards, and it's a Cleveland first down.
And a Browns first down.
Before he crosses over out of bounds. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Now Hunt. And he'll take this one down near the 15. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
That call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That was a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
They stay on the ground. Again, it's Hunt. Now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. It's a gain of 6, moves him to a manageable 3rd-and-2 situation.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
And he picks up the first as he's able to take it down to the 7-yard line. He'll wind up getting 2 there as he does it himself and picks up the first. A field goal could get him the lead, but it might not be enough here as they come up on first and goal. They'll run with Hunt. And he'll be stopped up after only a couple of yards as he gets it down to the 5.
The ball carrier.
Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a third down.
And now third and goal coming up, the loss on second down. That just means this crowd's going to get even louder, and they'll get a little bit of extra help from the defenders as they exhort them to join them in the effort.
Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. So the Browns in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They come up on what could be a pivotal third and goal now in a tie ball game. Eluding the pressure right. And this is caught. Touchdown, Cleveland. From 6 yards away. And the Browns have moved out in front.
Hey, that score deserves our respect, deserves our excitement. But I'm looking at the clock and I'm thinking, there's a long way to go in this one.
Ideally, they would have liked to milk a little bit more time off. Now on the other sideline, you start to get the crew together and say, this is what we practiced a 2-minute drill for, right?
Yeah, you hope you've been in that situation before. And if you haven't, you just have the confidence, hey, let's go down there and get this thing done. But boy, that's a big score right there to give them the advantage.
This one taken just inside the 10. And they will wrangle it down a couple yards shy of the 30.
At their own 28-yard line.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave them great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do and the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down, it caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain. So now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
Six, and it'll be second down.
A 6-yard pickup brings up second and 4 at the 48-yard line.
They'll look to throw toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. This defense so strong all afternoon long, well executed again there.
This is a group that really functions well off of each other. No matter what the assignment, the other person fills in the exact proper spot. They've made it very, very hard for them to find open places to throw the football.
Now they face a third down and 4 after that incompletion on second down. Throw there, going to be incomplete. What a great sequence by this defense so far. They've given him nowhere to go with the football.
And they just have to make it stand up one more time because it appears that they've got their number. Can they not have a slip up here and allow the touchdown?
Game on the line, season on the line. They're going for it here on fourth down. Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Down 7, and they've got to go for it here on fourth down. Going quickly out to the right side. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. And the drive stays in motion with a nice 8-yard pickup on fourth. Back to throw. Throwing for his running back, he's got him complete. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. Now the Steelers use the first of their 3 timeouts as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this fourth quarter. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. He's back to throw. Now they go screen. It's complete. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. Another connection between the two. This one good for 12 and a first down. The Steelers signal for the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in the football game. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Back to throw. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked up by the Honey Badger, Tyrann Mathieu. And he will bring it out past the 20-yard line.
Intercepted by the Browns. They'll take over first and 10 at their own 21-yard line.
The Browns in victory formation now as they take the knee.
Today's
the Browns going to roll on as we say so long, everybody. Thanks for watching. For us, for Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaughton. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. With that, we sign off from Heinz Field.
They did not want me to go places. Foil plans like the gold place. And if we pulling up with the whole squad, I get ready to told y'all that you better be running. I'm in my goal yard. When I walk in, I know y'all telling me nothing. I'm the man. Sucker if y'all in denial. I get the chip on him and I bust out the south side. Is that Vigo de Gallo?
Boy, yo, stop it, quiet. If it's snow, I done got it. See my jewels, shining, shining. White diamonds, Miley Cyrus. Private jet, private pilot. Look at me, stylish, stylish. Masterpiece, body, body. Young, hey.
We got momentum, don't try to stop it. Diamonds are clearer than my conscience. I don't let bygones be bygones. It's that's when I'm honest. Penthouse building, reach heaven's heights. Now that's what you call a God complex.
Remember the days I was down low when it was out cold, but I went out and got it. Look at my milestones, man, it feel like the Dow Jones when you look at my pocket.
Look at the flex, yeah. Whipping the Teslas.
Ooh,
I'm a mess, girl, I'm a ooh. It's all a finesse.
Ooh. Boy, yo, stop it, quiet. If it's new, I done got it. See my jewels, shining, shining. White diamonds, Miley Cyrus. Private jet, private pilot. Look at me, stylish, stylish.
Masterpiece, body, body. Young, hey. No, but I'm on this every day. You cannot run with me, boy, I'm a heavyweight. Baby, I know what's coming, I could barely wait. And when it was on, they wanted me gone, boy, I'm here to stay. Stop calling me little bro, I got mileage on me. Walked in with the whole team and we riding on it. More action and no talk, I went quiet on it. Walked in with the whole team and we riding on it.
Let me explain what I did, can I kick? Hold on, yeah, I got some rings and a ring, can I kick it, yeah. Don't ask me a thing, how I got her, how I did it, yeah. Spend the whole half, had a blast, can I kick it, yeah. Even with a sprain, pain, can I kick it? Just the flex, I went and bought a chain, can I kick it? Things ain't been the same, things have changed, can I kick it? People acting different, so I ask, can I?
Hey, could count on my power and look at my dogs from... Way back then, claim what you saw, but you weren't with us. The higher the climb, the harder the fall, but how did you get up?